Alright guys, I've had a lot of comments on painting metals of how I'm able to achieve the look that I get. I know there's lots of guys that can do a really good job on metals as well. This is just how I do it. But before I even start, I just want to take a few seconds and talk about preparing the actual model before you paint it. You can see that I drilled out all of these and removed mold lines. Guys, if you don't spend the extra time, it's those details that really can screw up bang up paint jobs. So take your time, have some patience, and set the model up properly before you throw paint on it. One of the guys early on said it's like putting lipstick on a pig. No matter what shade the lipstick is, it's still a pig. So prepare the model first. And then your paint will only enhance your great results that you get. Here we start with Chaos Black, primed. I guess it's not a true primer, but based in Chaos Black. I actually mix this pot. What this pot is about 50% Chaos Black and 50% bolt gun metal. So it's really dark, so let me show you the difference. If I can find my bolt gun metal here, just so that you can see the shading difference of the two. Typically what I do is I make a whole pot of it because I use it so much. I start with about half of bolt gun metal and add black to it. Don't do it the other way around. Trying to add bolt gun metal to black, yeah, you might not get the right effect. Always add the darker color, the lighter color. So anyhow, first step, which is essentially a very light dry brush. I want to say light. I'm not trying to fill the model with the metal. You can see there's still some black in there that doesn't get covered. So it's almost like it's a dry brush, but it's very quick and easy. This is actually one of the very first steps I do anytime I'm painting an orc vehicle, is paint the whole model this color right here. Black and then this. And that's the basic step, start of my metals. Just go over it. You want to leave some black showing, but don't panic if you do cover it. It's always start lighter than it is trying to take it away. So now we move on to bolt gun metal, and this is a very almost like a lighter dry brush. I'm just trying to catch the edges of it. Like so. Oops. And the next step is chainmail. And again, this is even more of a light dry brush. Now, when I'm doing the chainmail, I'm not going straight across. I'm just trying to get the edges. So very little paint on your brush, and you just pick out the edges with highlighting. So right off the bat, it's taken me probably about 30 seconds to give this a pretty good look of metal so far. You don't want to go too heavy with this because I'm still going to do a highlight with chainmail. So there's your three dry brush. So 50-50 Chaos Black, bolt gun metal, then bolt gun metal, then chainmail. Now we're going to move on is chainmail. Now, first off, I'm going to pick these out because I want these brighter. Just like they're sort of rings that hold the barrels together. I'm painting through a camera here again, so I'm not going to be as good as what I could probably do just to my bare eye. But I just want to share this technique. There's been quite a few people that have asked how I pull the metals off. And now we'll do some highlighting. On this, guys, it's not really a big deal if you screw up. I'm going to show you why. So let's say, for instance, we are going to... Now, this is going to be covered anyhow, so I might as well use this as a demo. I'm just doing a hard highlight. And let's say I get a great big glob of paint there. Well, this is metal, so what I do is I drag it back and make it look like a scratch. So it's not a big deal if this is very fine highlights. You see that? Let's do the side. Now this side here, same thing. We're not going to see it. I'm just using this as a display. Or demo, I should say. You're not going to see it, but see how I pull that back at the corners? And it now looks like it's been scratched. Fresher metal where those scratches are. And that is how I do my metals. Just start picking it out now. Now you see here how I got wide there? Let's put a couple scratches there. Pick out the bottom. Still on camera here. See, it's not a dry brush, but I'm not being too finicky here. It's not like when I was painting the hulls of the Land Raiders. That was more finicky. I just work at it like this. This is kind of the easy part of painting metals because it just doesn't have to be perfect, and if you do get a little bit extra, you just make it look like it's a scratch. Now in here, I'm going to try and pick out these parts. If it's too much of a hard highlight for you, just give it a bit of black wash. Put on some liquid talent. Lately, I haven't been doing that. Now, you're going to see the barrels. I'm leaving that darker metal, and I'll get to that in a second, what I want you to do with that. This is the exact same technique I do on the exhaust for any vehicles now, Orcs or Space Marines. Base it in 50-50. Base it in Chaos Black, then do a light dry brush of that 50-50 mix, and that would be the pipe color, and then we're going to add two washes to make it look like it's hot. So that's my metals. It's as simple as that. Very easy, quick, effective method. So let's add the washes and we'll discolor these barrels to show like they're hot. The color I'm going to add, guys, is a Sermon Blue wash, and you just put it to the pipes. Make sure I'm on camera here. Or to the barrels, I should say, not the pipes. Thanks to you guys for sticking with me through this series of Land Raiders. Well, there's been a lot of videos, but there's a lot of information of how I've done some of the techniques I do. And guys, I know there's many better ways than mine. I just find mine is simple, effective, and I can use common colors that you guys might already have. So I essentially just do all the barrels blue. Like so. Let that dry. See, the blue is somewhat dried. I'm sort of forcing this video, if you will. Not a big deal. The next step is Leviathan Purple. And just so you guys know, when I'm doing the exhaust in these barrels, I don't go over the whole thing. You just see that I'm picking out different spots with the purple, because you don't want it even. I'm trying to get it that it's, maybe put some purple where these rings are, because that where the heat would be built up. And I'm not too concerned with the end because I put soot marks on that, and you'll see that in a sec. This effect looks really cool when it's dry. You might not see it now, but when the land raiders are done, guys, I'll do close-ups of all this stuff so that you can see. Of Chaos Black, and what this does is just give it a look of soot. So I start on the end and draw it towards the barrel of the gun. I'm trying to make it look like it's sort of a gunpowder flash. And this needs to be somewhat random, don't make it even. And go over everything where it's. Now with the metals, one last thing is that if this was for an orc vehicle, I would actually be applying Devlin mud to the entire model, so it would really make the metal even more dirty. But I don't want that effect for Space Marines. I want theirs to be a little bit cleaner. So there you can see there's still a little bit of metal showing, and that's why I painted it. Paint it first and then add the soot after. Make sure the absolute end and tip very black. Other than that, that's about it, guys. Hopefully this helps somebody out there. I know it might be basic, but this is just the method of how I do this effect. Cheers and bye-bye.